So we learned this from the Prophet ﷺ. He said, "ثلاثة أقسم عليهن." Like three things I would swear by Allah Azza wa Jalla, you should maintain, you should memorize from me. He says, don't worry about your giving charity, because it would not take your money away from you. It will actually increase the barakah in it. The second thing is that if someone wrongs you, be patient with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate your status as a result of that. And again, don't go after the easy money. Go, you know, make sure that you learn a skill, learn so hard to make it, inshallah, to happen, bidnillah azza wa jal. In this hadith that we have tonight, inshallah, there's a very short hadith. It shows about the generosity of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the book of Al-Karam wal-Jud, the excellence of generosity, qala Imam an-Nawawi rahimahullah, وعن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها أنهم ذبحوا شاة. عائشة رضي الله عنها, she reported that one of those days that they have sacrificed a goat or a lamb. قالت فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما بقي منها. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gave the instruction earlier to distribute that meat, like, you know, give this away. And then after some time later on the day, he came by and he asked his family, he goes, ما بقي منها, what did you guys leave? I mean, what is left out of that animal? قالت عائشة رضي الله عنها, عائشة, she said, ما بقي منها إلا كتفها. She said, the only thing that stays, or the one that we kept for you, is the shoulder. He goes, no, بقي كلها غير كتفها, أو غير كتفها. He said, no. And everything stayed except for the shoulder. What does that mean? He's now creating more of like what you could call a paradigm shift, like, you know, a complete change of perception of things. Because we always think that what you keep in your hand is what stays with you. Obviously, physically speaking, whatever that you have in your bank account, you can see the numbers increasing or decreasing, that's what stays with you. But the Prophet ﷺ is correcting that concept for us. He says, no, this is not what you keep for yourself. What you keep for yourself is the thing that you give away in charity. Because everything else, what happens to it, Jama'ah? It perishes or stayed for other people after you die. Like in the other hadith, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, يقول الرجل, a person would say, مالي, مالي. They keep saying, my money, my money. And the Prophet ﷺ says to him, or this person, what is your money anyway, except for what you eat and you consume, what you wear wears out, and then what you give, and it stays for you in charity. Which means, whatever that is the real money that you have, is the one that you enjoy. Anything that is above that, it's in your bank account. What exactly, I mean, what are you getting out of it, other than just that feeling, elusive feeling of security, alhamdulillah, I have enough money. Is that gonna save you from death? It doesn't give you that safety from death. So the real money that you keep for yourself is the one that you send ahead of you, or send it forward before you die. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who are generous. Ya Rabbil Alameen. Wallahu alam. Any question, Jama'ah? MashaAllah. Very quiet night. Alhamdulillah. Subhanakallah wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka.